Hey, what's up guys? I'm doing a Red Ice Black Dragon deck profile. This is missing still a couple cards, or like maybe one, which is one more Blackstone Legend. I only have two. But I'm gonna hold off on ordering those until the Invasion of Vengeance pre-orders for singles are out. And then I will be updating Red Eyes when I get the stuff from Invasion of Vengeance in, when I order that. So, yeah. And Red Eyes will probably be a deck that I'll be playing in this format, as well, because it's really, really good, and the new support for it, makes it a lot more better. I won't say OP, but I would say a lot more better. So, yeah. So, without any further ado, let's get on with the deck profile. So, two, soon to be three, the Blackstone of Legend. Basically, what you can do with this is you can basically tribute this card, especially on a level 4 or a level 7 or lower Red Eyes from your deck. And then, while this card is in your graveyard, you can add this card back to your hand and then shuffle in a level 7 or lower Red Eyes monster back into your deck. So. And then 3 Summon Skull. And then 3 Red Eyes just for gem normal monsters for Red Eyes Fusion. So, and then 1 Red Eyes Black Flare Dragon. I went with the 3-1 for this build just because you need a normal monster in your deck in order to send for Red Eyes Fusion, and so that's why I decided to go with the 3 regular Red Eyes Black Dragon and then 1 Flare Dragon. So, and then 2 Retro Dragon. It's basically a monster reborn from your hand. So basically when Red Eyes monsters are destroyed by Valor by card effect, you can special summon this card in defense, and then if you do, special summon as many the destroyed monsters as possible in the same position. So it's a very, very good card, and it helps with keeping a strong field. So yeah. And then Black Metal Dragon. I only run 2, in my opinion. Just use it, it's a good card for power boost, for gaining more attack, but I just like 2 for now. Use it's just a good number, so yeah. And then 1 Darkness Smell Dragon for use it's, you know, kind of staple for any dragon deck, so yeah. And then 2 Fight Fire, and then 1 Spear Mode. The Spear Mode is to help you out, like, totally awesome, is what the TCG name is. But I like Tree Toad, so it's just to help you out that, so. And then for Repose, 3 MST, 3 Red Eyes Fusion, 2 cards of the redstone to help you draw more into combo pieces that you really need, and plus it helps you make your redstone a lot more alive, so yeah. And then the other thing too is that the new level 6 Gemini that's out in Invasion of Vengeance, I will be getting 2 of those. This spell I only really need 1, so it'll be a 45 card deck after I get all that. And then for the fusions, the new fusion that's in Invasion of Vengeance, I am going to gain 2 of those. So, yeah. So just to give you guys an update on what I'll be gaining for this, but like I said, I'll still be doing an update when that stuff actually comes out. So, Runes of the Divine Dragon Lord. This card's really, really quite good with combination of Archfiend, so, Yeah. So it just kind of helps lock down your front board with a bill beefy monster, so yeah. And then return of the Dragon Lords to help protect from being destroyed by a battle or by card effect. And then it's also a monster reborn for dragons, so it's very, very quite good. Forbidden Lance, very, very quite good. And then here's an interesting tech card. Magical Mallet and Reload. Because you will kind of brick a lot in this deck, and these three cards are in here to help you unbrick. So, yeah, that's basically why I put them in here. So, yeah. And then two Jar of Avarice, four Recycle, so you can continue with your plays and have resources so that way you can kind of try to make a comeback. So, yeah. Bombless, Warning, Compulse, and then one of my favorite cards for out of like the whole trap lineup is Skill Prisoner. Skill Prisoner is a card that I never really knew about too much, but as soon as I found out about it and knew what it did, it became one of my favorites. Because it helps protect your monster from like Honor Arc, Castell, Diamond Direwolf, and all that other stuff. Because what this does is that you target a card that you control, and when there's a monster effect that targets it, it negates it. And so it helps protect your monster from like being targeted, or maybe like a spell or trap that you want to keep on the board that your opponent is targeting, then that helps protect it as well. So it's just a very, very, very good card, and it just helps out a lot. And then the other thing that you can do with this as well is that you can banish it from your graveyard, and then it does the same effect. So it's versatile both ways, so it's very, very quite good. I really like it. So, and then for extra deck, three Archfiend, and then three Red Ice Flare Mile Drawing. And that's basically it for extra deck. There's not really much to this. I guess I know I can throw in like Big Eye, Draco Sack, and other stuff in here, which I might actually do, but that's basically the extra deck for now. But when, like I said, Invasion of Vengeance comes out, I will definitely throw in a lot of stuff in here. Heretic Dragon of Tomb, which is very, very quite good, and a lot of other things as well. So, yeah, so thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more. And yeah, I'll catch y'all in the next video. Later.